Lesson 2G, Drawing the Side View. This lesson completes the third view of the concrete block. It explains how to use the Polyline option of the Chamfer command to easily chop off all the corners of an object at once. It also reviews object snap tracking, layers, the scale command, and dimensioning. So far we have completed the front view, the top view, so let us also complete the side view as well. And look at this rectangle here. We know we could draw this easily by referencing these endpoints. So let's get a little bit of help from our object snap tracking again by clicking this to make it turn on. Also right click on object snap and check the settings. Make sure endpoint, midpoint, and intersection options are on. And object snap itself is on. Also, let's turn off the ortho mode now. You could also press F8 to turn it on and off. Now, before we start drawing, it's a good habit to make sure that we are on the right layer. We're drawing solid lines on the layer 0. Now we're ready to draw the rectangle, which has these dimensions, 2025 and 1350. Now we'll try to touch the endpoint of this line here. And move your mouse to the left and you'll see this green line. And click, say here, and this point has the correct Y coordinate at some comfortable X distance away from the front view. And we need to enter in the delta x, delta y value, so type in the at sign. And delta x is going to be negative since we're going to the left 2025. Comma. And the y value is going to be positive 1. So it's going to be 1350. Enter. And the rectangle is done. Now we need to chop off the corners using chamfer again. But this time let me show you an even easier way. So the chamfer command is here, and if you don't see it, maybe you're looking at fillet, so just pick chamfer. And the distance has been set at 1440. But now we're gonna choose this polyline option, which works great for our purpose. Now choose P for polyline option. And this rectangle, it's created as one polyline. So if you click this polyline, it's going to chop off all the corners, as you can see here. Okay, so now let's put in the solid lines. We'll be using the line command from corner to corner. Then spacebar to exit, and then another spacebar to repeat the command line. And then from here to the same point. Then you could press escape or spacebar to exit. Now we're gonna need the center line here. So we'll go back to the center line layer. And we'll draw a line from this midpoint to this other midpoint. And beware that at this point, it might be more convenient if you switch off the object snap tracking. So snap to the midpoint and then press enter. And again, we want to make it stick out of the object a little bit, so we'll use the scale command again. Pick the center line you want to scale, to enter, and pick the midpoint as the base point, and give it a value of, say, 1.3 to make it come out. And finally, we can go to the dimension layer, and press annotate, and dimensions, linear. And we can dimension this horizontal distance, for example. Now, if it's convenient, you might want to zoom in to make sure that you snap to the correct points, which is this endpoint to this endpoint. You could also use the wheel on the mouse to zoom in and out. And also press down to pan.
Okay, so now let's try to finish the dimensioning.
And we're done!